Welcome to Jackal Digital. I'm Simon, and today we'll track a Mini Cooper and the balloons, and add some fun callouts to them. You can do this whenever you want to add some information to an object, so the viewer knows what you're talking about. Now let's see how I did it. I have the original clip here, it's a little bit washed out for my taste, so I did some basic color grading to make it pop out. Anyway, once you have the video, you'll want to cut it, where the object or the subject is fully visible, and where you'll apply the callouts at. We'll be doing the tracking in Fusion, so we want to keep it simple and make it easy to animate. Now let's jump into Fusion and see how I did it. As you can see, the color grade is not applied here, it's applied at the end. So at the start, you have the media in and the media out. We'll want to add a tracker node, you'll want to add this tracking node, and depending on the clip, you may not need to do anything else. And it looks like this. Why? Because I used a contrast node. And why I used the contrast node is because I tried to use two different trackers inside one. Now this didn't make much sense in this clip, because the balloons and the curve were moving in the same direction. But if you had two objects moving at different speeds or in different directions, then you could do something like this. So the first tracker that I've used is tracking the headlights, mainly this strip. And the second one is tracking the balloons. I tracked both of them at once, and the headlight tracked fine. When I press this button, track forward, but the balloons stayed at the same place or jumped through the roof and went on. So let's make it an example. What I mean by this, so, and the tracking node, this one headlamp, this one balloon. Well, what can I say? Now the balloons tracked fine, but the headlamp didn't. So anyway, what I did for the balloons, and in this case I could do for the lamp. I can try the lamp one more time, just with the default settings. You can then disable the tracker. No, this one's one, okay, so I will disable the second one since it did fine. And I'll track again the headlamp to see how it does this time. Doesn't look like it's doing much better. So we can then introduce a contrast node. Introduce it before the tracker. Then just play around with the settings so you can get the best contrast that you can. Maybe something like this. This is pretty much now black and white, so you should do fine. And let's test it. Somewhere along the way, it lost its way. And now I did fine without the contrast. So as you have seen, you may not need the contrast, and it just depends on how lucky you get with the selections that you do. After I got the tracking done, I added two text nodes, went to the center X position, connected it to, I need a new node so I can show you. Connected it to, in this case, it would be on tracker 2, path 1, and the other one would be path 2. But as you can see from the animation, the balloons were jumping up and down, and if I wanted a steady animation, I could also use the same path as this one, because this one is pretty solid. So when you have it connected, you then also, well, let me just connect it and type something in. And if I know, connected it here, so we can see it. So now it's just in the center position. And if you want to move it, just insert vector origin vector result, and now you can move it. And it will stay in that position and follow the animation line. As you can see, I've done the polygon in the center position. This made it easier to move around later on. So if I add a polygon and the background node, you can see it. Then I zoomed in the center position. You can also do it here. Now it's really big, but you can just size it down. And then you will want to do the same thing. Connect it to one of the trackers and to move it also vector origin. And now you can position how you want. The same thing applies with everything else. So with the mask paint, we have to control space. Type paint and select the mask paint, edit, I'll connect it to this background. You'll want to select the polyline stroke. You can click anywhere you want to start, and then you can hold shift to get 45 degree angles and hold the mouse button down while doing this if you want straight lines. And what's good about this tool is that you can then go to stroke controls. You will probably want to reduce the softness and maybe the size of it, but then you can use the write on function to animate it easily. You can just go to a position that you want, click the keyframe, write off, move in, write on, so get something like this. In the second part, I've used a B-spline instead of a polygon because it has round corners by default, so I didn't have to play around with that. I only adjusted the levels at the beginning, so it was off, and I showed it when it came in. You do everything the same when it comes to the animation. Center X position, connect to the tracker path that you chose, and then insert vector origin result so you can move it. When it comes to the animation, all other elements were static, but this one moves. How I achieved that is that I connected the center position to one of the tracking path nodes and inserted the vector origin vector result. I positioned it at the beginning, so it was at this height, but then to achieve the animation, I then selected all of the points that make the balloon. I went keyframe by keyframe, reposition the element, until the animation was done. And then at the end of the animation, I had it so that the rope kind of breaks away, vanishes, as you can see on the right on, and the balloon flies away. When it comes to making an effect like this, I would say The most problems that you may have is with tracking, as we saw. So when you have the tracking done, it's smooth sailing. Well, depending on what the animation you want to achieve is. One thing I didn't mention yet is the rectangles for the text. They are just masks. So for the text to not show all the time, there is the rectangle. Anything that's outside of it is not visible. So I then animate it that it comes in. And at the end, I animate it that it comes out. Similarly with this one, it comes in and it goes out. And that's it when it comes to this video. If you found it helpful, give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell notification icon so you don't miss my next video. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital!